Welcome back to Chemistry Matters and our unit on nuclear chemistry. With a solid understanding of atomic structure and radioactivity, let's now look at how atoms can break apart in nuclear fission to make different elements. In our classroom cloud chambers, you were able to see paths left by subatomic particles being emitted from atoms. We call this radioactive decay. When a radioactive atom decays, there are three important products: alpha particles, beta particles, and gamma radiation. The other particle that remains after nuclear decay is called the daughter nuclide. Let's take a look at how alpha, beta, and gamma decay occur. Here's a diagram of a uranium-238 atom. It undergoes alpha decay, producing one alpha particle and a daughter nuclide. As you can see here, the alpha particle is made up of two protons and two neutrons. It's essentially a helium nucleus without the electrons, giving it a 2+ charge. You'll recall alpha particles from Unit 3, when we studied Rutherford's gold foil experiment. The alpha particles were deflected in unexpected ways, which led Rutherford to identify the nucleus of the atom. And as you know from the last video on the Unit 11 playlist, an isotope is defined as atoms of the same element with different numbers of neutrons. Isotope notation is a common method for communicating information about a single atom or radioactive particle. So this is a good time to learn how to write isotope notation to represent radioactive particles. Let's use a familiar atom to show you what I mean. To write the isotope for one sodium atom, first write the chemical symbol for sodium, Na. On the lower left, write the number of protons, known as the atomic number, as a subscript before the symbol. For sodium, the atomic number is 11. The mass number, total mass of the protons plus neutrons, is written as a superscript before the symbol. For sodium, the mass number is 23. Even though you know that sodium forms a positive ion, we do not typically show the charge of the atom in isotope notation format. Isotope notation is all about the nucleus, not what's happening outside the nucleus. And sometimes this notation will exclude the atomic number, since you can easily find that number on the periodic table from the symbol. With that in mind, let's write the isotope notation for an alpha particle. Remember that an alpha particle is made of two protons and two neutrons, so an alpha particle is one helium nucleus. To represent an alpha particle, just start with the element symbol for helium, He, in the center. The atomic number of helium is 2, so write that as a subscript before the symbol. The mass number is 4, so write that as a superscript before the symbol. Notice again that we didn't place the charge of 2+ in the top right corner. Many scientists prefer to use the Greek letter alpha to represent the alpha particle, and there are actually three accepted ways to represent this particle. The Greek letter alpha I just mentioned, or the Greek letter alpha with the atomic number and mass number, or the helium symbol with the atomic number and mass number. Now let's try using isotope notation to write a balanced nuclear equation. A radioactive material that's probably in the room with you right now is americium-241. You'll find it's a very important part of common household smoke detectors. To draw the proper isotope notation of americium-241, find the element symbol for americium on the periodic table, AM. Write that down. Now write its atomic number on the lower left. Americium has 95 protons. The mass number of americium-241 is found in its name, so write 241 as the mass number on the upper left. When a radioactive atom, like americium-241, undergoes alpha decay, it releases an alpha particle. The alpha particle, composed of two protons and two neutrons, goes flying away. Remember, this is the symbol for the alpha particle, a mass number of 4 and an atomic number of 2. But what about the rest of the protons and neutrons in the americium-241 atom? As you know from Unit 5, the law of conservation of matter says matter cannot be created or destroyed. So something had to happen to the rest of the protons, neutrons, and electrons of the americium-241 atom. In fact, aside from the two protons and two neutrons that were emitted with the alpha particle, they're all still there, just in a nucleus that's now smaller. This new nucleus that's left behind is what we call the daughter nuclide. It's what's left after the alpha particle is emitted. Notice that after undergoing alpha decay, the daughter nuclide has lost two protons, so it only has 93 protons remaining. Therefore, it's not americium anymore. Check the periodic table. What element has 93 protons? It's neptunium, and the element symbol is NP. Now, what's the mass number of this new neptunium atom? Since the atom lost four nuclear particles, two protons and two neutrons, subtract 4 from the mass number of americium. 241 minus 4 equals 237. So write 237 as the mass number of the daughter nuclide, neptunium. You have now completed your first nuclear equation. As with any equation in chemistry, the law of conservation of matter that you learned about in Unit 5 applies. Notice how the mass numbers on the right side add up to 241, and that equals the mass number on the left side. We can also add up the atomic numbers in the same way. 95 on the left side and a total of 95 on the right side. The second product that can be caused by radioactive decay is a beta particle. You can think of it as simply as an electron. We represent it with a Greek letter beta, a B shape with a little tail. Here's what happens during beta decay. One neutron turns into one proton. The atom therefore gains a proton, loses a neutron, and releases an electron that we call a beta particle. It's not one of the electrons that was in energy levels around the atom. It's a beta particle, a new electron made when a neutron actually changed into a proton. It'll help you understand this by learning how to write the isotope notation for a beta particle. So let's write the isotope notation for one beta particle. Start by writing the Greek letter beta, or if you prefer, you can just write E for electron. The mass number will be 0, since there are no protons or neutrons. Write the mass number at the top left. Now, here's something strange that happens in beta decay. The only way for a beta particle to form is for a neutron to turn into a proton. Chemists assign the atomic number -1 as the atomic number of a beta particle. So write -1 on the lower left as the atomic number of the beta particle. I realize that you have not heard about this in any of our previous units. That's because nuclear chemistry is different in many ways from the other forms of chemistry you've studied. Now let's write the nuclear equation for the beta decay of the isotope carbon-14. Carbon has an atomic number of 6, and this radioactive isotope of carbon has a mass number of 14, 6 protons and 8 neutrons. When beta decay occurs, one neutron turns into a proton. The atom has one more proton than it did before, changing the atomic number to 7. The atomic mass is still 14, 7 protons plus 7 neutrons. Which element has an atomic number of 7? The periodic table has the answer. It's nitrogen. The daughter nuclide is nitrogen-14, and a beta particle is emitted. Add the mass numbers and the atomic numbers on each side to ensure that they're equal. The atomic number on the left is 6. The atomic numbers on the right are 7 and -1, and 7 plus a -1 equals 6. The mass number on the left is a total of 14. On the right, the mass number is 14 plus 0, which equals 14. So our nuclear equation balances. The third product of radioactive decay that we know about is gamma radiation. Gamma radiation is the energy released along with an alpha or beta particle. Gamma radiation is energy. And as you know, energy is not matter. So when gamma decay occurs, an atom emits very powerful energy. We represent gamma radiation with the Greek letter gamma, which kind of looks like a fancy Y. The isotope notation for the gamma radiation shows that it has no mass and no atomic number, because it's radiation, which is energy. Gamma radiation is emitted with all types of radioactivity. They're the energy released along with an alpha or beta particle to make the radioactive nucleus more stable. This equation shows the gamma decay of thorium-230. You can tell that the thorium atom undergoes alpha decay because you can see the alpha particle on the right-hand side of the nuclear equation. The daughter nuclide is now radium-226, an element with two less protons than thorium. And what does this Greek letter gamma mean? It lets us know that gamma radiation was released as a part of this alpha decay. We usually call this a gamma emission. Gamma radiation is very high energy with no mass, and since it's a type of light energy, it travels very quickly, technically at, well, the speed of light. Because of its energy and speed, it can also be damaging because it can penetrate human tissue. So now's a good time for an explanation of how to shield yourself from different kinds of radiation. Alpha particles are the heaviest radioactive particles, and also the slowest. You can be shielded from alpha particles easily by thin metal foils, skin, or even paper. Beta particles are slower and have less energy than gamma rays, but are faster and more energetic than alpha particles. Beta particles cannot penetrate metal sheets at least a half centimeter thick, or dense wood, or even heavy clothing. Gamma rays carry the most energy of the three radioactive decay products. Thick concrete or lead is needed to shield or stop gamma rays. Okay, that was a lot to take in. This chart summarizes it nicely. It's a graphic organizer for helping you remember the characteristics of alpha particles, beta particles, and gamma rays. And it's available in our Chemistry Matters toolkit. So now, take a more in-depth look at nuclear equations and get a different look at carbon-14. Let's get back to our classroom to see how we can model these processes and practice using them.
At this point in the unit, it will be helpful for us to build nuclear models so we can make sure we understand the forms of radioactive decay, alpha, beta, and gamma. I'll put the periodic table on the monitor. Use your magnetic model kits to build a carbon-14 nucleus. And because we're working in the realm of nuclear chemistry, which is concerned about the nucleus of the atom, not the electrons, you don't need to show the electrons in these models.
Okay, carbon has 6 protons, so I'll put 6 protons in the nucleus.
And on the periodic table, it says carbon has an atomic mass of 12.01. So the mass number of the most common isotope must be 12. I'll add 6 neutrons, right?
Wait, we're supposed to build carbon-14. That means there is a mass number of 14. So there's actually 8 neutrons, not 6.
Oh yeah, 6 protons plus 8 neutrons to give us a mass number of 14. Carbon-14 is an isotope of carbon.
Good, add 8 neutrons. There, a carbon-14 nucleus.
That's what we got, too.
Good. You've both built your carbon-14 nuclei. Now try to show what happens when carbon-14 undergoes beta decay.
I'll try. A beta particle is emitted when a neutron suddenly changes into a proton. Then the beta particle, the electron, is released.
Good. Now count the number of protons and neutrons you have in your new nucleus.
Well, we have 7 protons now.
And 1 neutron changed into a proton. So we only have 7 neutrons now.
Exactly. And the law of conservation of matter reminds us that mass and matter, they can't be created or destroyed. So although we're showing an atom undergoing decay, the total mass of the reactants and the products in the nuclear equation will stay the same. Now that the atom has lost a neutron and gained a proton, what's the new mass number?
Well, 1 neutron changed to a proton. So if the old mass number was 14, the new mass number will still be 14.
Right. And now that our atom has gained a proton, what else has happened?
It's not carbon anymore. Carbon has to have 6 protons to be carbon.
Exactly. So what is the new atom? You can look at the periodic table for help.
Well, our new atom has 7 protons, which means it has an atomic number of 7. So the carbon-14 has changed into nitrogen-14.
Good job. Now let's practice writing this out in an equation. This is a great way to visualize the same reaction, but in a different way. Use your whiteboards to do this. Let's start with a carbon-14 nucleus. The symbol for carbon is C, so write a C. The mass number is 14, so put a 14 in the upper left-hand corner. The atomic number is 6, and that goes in the bottom left-hand corner underneath the 14. Then we want to represent carbon-14 going through beta decay. Now, decay is like decomposition. It's breaking down, so there are no other reactants. But we need to know the other products. We know it was beta decay, and that means a neutron was converted into a proton.
That still seems so strange to me, a neutron turning into a proton.
I agree. Nuclear chemistry is very different from the other chemistry we've studied so far in this course. But for the scope of this course, it isn't necessary to explain exactly how this transformation occurs. But you should know that many scientists are trying to answer this question right now. For our purposes, you know that a neutron turns into a proton during beta decay. So, can you show an equation in which the daughter nuclide formed after a neutron has been changed into a proton?
Well, we had 6 protons and 8 neutrons. 1 neutron changed into a proton. That left us with 7 protons and 7 neutrons.
So our mass number stays 14, and the 7 goes below it to represent the atomic number.
And that means our equation needs to include a nitrogen atom, right?
Yes, but why?
Because nitrogen contains 7 protons, and that's what the daughter nuclei has.
Good. But what else happens?
Well, a beta particle is released from the nucleus.
And beta particle is just an electron.
Right. So add that beta particle to your equation. Good. Now there's a mass number of 0 and an atomic number of -1, which help to balance the equation, a total mass number of 14 on both sides, and a total atomic number of 6 on both sides. Well done, both groups. Now that you have a better understanding of nuclear decay, try writing the following 2 nuclear decay equations. First of all, represent nitrogen-15 going through beta decay, and then uranium-235 going through alpha and then beta decay. And based on what you now know about nuclear reactions, write the nuclear decay equations for these 2 scenarios using isotope notation. And don't forget, both processes will be accompanied by gamma radiation, so you'll need to include that on your board as well.
We'll take a break here to let you get started with practice writing nuclear equations using isotope notation for the 2 examples our teacher just gave us. Remember, you need to write the complete nuclear equations. If you need additional practice, you can find additional practice problems in our Chemistry Matters toolkit. When you're done, join us at the top of the next video on the Unit 11 playlist, where we'll see how your equations compare to those of our students.